Hey everybody, this is video of the week number 11. This is just going to be a really brief introduction to exponential functions and to logarithms. Now here's an example of an exponential function, y equals 2 to the power of x. If you wanted to investigate what that graph might look like, you might start with a little table of x and y values. And maybe I'll make up a few x values right here to plug into our equation. Don't forget that if you plug in x equals 0, you get 2 to the 0, and anything to the 0 power is just 1. If you plug in x equals 1, you get 2 to the first power. If you plug in x equals 2, you get 2 to the second power, which is 4. And if you plug in x equals 3, you get 2 to the third power, which is 8. If you plug in a negative number for x, you get a negative exponent. You might have to go back and review your negative exponents. But if you plug in x equals negative 1, you get 1 half. And if you plug in x equals negative 2, you're going to get 1 fourth. Now we can plot all of these points on our xy plane over here. They're going to look something like this. And if we connect all of our dots with a curve, our exponential function ends up looking something like this. This is a horizontal asymptote that this function approaches at y equals 0. And there's not a vertical asymptote over here. You might ask the question, what does y equals 4 to the x look like? And the answer is it looks pretty similar, it's just that it grows a whole lot faster. It's also important to point out that there is a very special exponential graph in between these two, y equals e to the x, where e is some irrational number, just like pi is. It's a number that goes on forever without repeating, 2.71828 and so on. It's worth noting that all basic exponential functions pass through that same point, 0, 1. Of course, in this chapter, we're going to take these exponential functions and shift them up and down and left and right, and after you do that, they'll no longer pass through 0, 1. But the basic exponential functions do. That, of course, is because if you plug in x equals 0 into any of these exponential functions, you get something to the 0 power, and that is always 1. Okay, in this chapter, you're going to learn about inverses, and most students don't struggle too much with inverses, so I just want to talk about the inverse of exponential functions. Now, the inverse of exponential functions are called logarithms, and we're going to talk about these for the rest of the video. I'll start by showing you a graph of what a logarithm looks like. Now you learned that if we graph the inverse of a function, it's like reflecting that function over the line y equals x right here. Or in other words, taking all of these points and switching the x and y values. So if we take y equals 2 to the x and switch all of the x values over, the graph looks something like this. And what we do is we call this y equals log base 2 of x. We could do the same thing with our log base 4 of x and our very special log base e of x. All we did was reflect the graphs above across the line y equals x. We took those graphs right there, we reflected them. That means that they're an inverse, and we're naming these things log base 2 of x, log base e of x, and log base 4 of x. Now that horizontal asymptote, y equals 0 from above, is now a vertical asymptote, x equals 0, and there is no horizontal asymptote here. Now this log base e of x is such a special function that we give it a different name. We call it the natural log of x, or log natural x. It's just that we happen to deal with this function, this log base e function, so often that we want to kind of shorten the name. Okay, so we just learned that exponential functions and logarithms are inverses, but really what is a logarithm? Let's think about that question by looking at a specific exponential function, y equals 2 to the x power. And if we think about taking an inverse of that exponential function, what we can do is we can just switch the x and y values. And to find our inverse of our original function in previous sections, what we would do then is we would solve for y. Of course, we don't really actually have a way to solve for y here, unless we invent something new. So the new thing that we invented is a logarithm. If we solve this equation right here for y, we get y equals the log base 2 of x. Okay, now this piece right here is actually quite important. So why don't we shed a little bit more light on what we're talking about by picking some very specific numbers. I'm going to plug in x equals 16. Now these two equations are exactly the same thing. This 16 equals 2 to the y, and this y equals log base 2 of 16. So what you can recognize by looking at these two equations is that this y, this logarithm right here, is actually just a power. You could probably come up with in your head what this y should be. 2 to what power equals 16? Well, if you thought about it, you would get that y should be 4. Likewise, this number right here should be 4. So the two equations that we have now that are exactly the same thing look like this. 16 equals 2 to the 4th power is the same thing as saying 4 is the log base 2 of 16. So what have we just learned? If we look at this equation right here, what we learned is that the log base 2 of 16 is the power on 2 that gives us 16, and that is 4. So as a quick example, what would the log base 10 of 100 be? It's the power on 10 that would give us 100. So 10 to what power is 100? Think about it for a while, and the answer is going to be 2. As another example, let's say, what is the log base 3 of 81? In other words, what is the power on 3 that would give us 81? Well, you might have to write it off on the side. How many times would you have to multiply 3 by itself to get 81? And the answer is 4. 3 to the 4th power is 81. Now these can get a little trickier, of course. Something like log base 2 of 1/4. What power on 2 would give us 1/4? You can think about it for a minute by hitting pause on your browser. I'm going to scroll back up to our very first example. We're asking 2 to what power gives us 1/4. If we look up at our original graph right at the beginning here, we wrote down that 2 to the negative 2 power gives us 1/4 right there. So the answer to the problem down here is just going to be negative 2. 2 to the negative 2 power is 1/4. Okay, remember up here when we were writing equations in two different forms? This looked like an exponential equation, and this was an equation with a logarithm in it. If we investigate that a little bit more generally, what we get is this. If we have a logarithmic equation, y equals log base a of x, it can be written as an exponential equation as well. A to the y equals x. And we can take any exponential equation and write it as a logarithmic equation just by moving the letters around. So just as an example, if you have yourself this logarithmic equation, m equals log base 2 of 17, we can take those letters and move them around appropriately based on this formula right here, and you would get the base is 2, the power on 2 is m, and the right side of this equation here is going to have to be 17. We're saying that m is the power on 2 that gives us 17. Likewise, if we had this equation right here in exponential form, we could write it as a logarithmic equation right here. Okay, now logarithms have a whole lot of properties. They're really very interesting and useful. So we'll talk about that more, but for now, I feel like that was a brief introduction to exponential equations, logarithmic equations, and what their graphs look like. Okay, I'll see you in the next video.